We've got local hockey scores from the weekend. Phil Lindemann with Krystal, 93 News. First, a Greyhound bus was stopped at the top of Vail Pass earlier this morning for an unruly passenger. Krystal 93 has confirmed with multiple sources that the stop was made around 6 a.m. today for a passenger with mental health issues. The bus continued on its way by 6:40 a.m. Law enforcement couldn't confirm if the passenger was removed from the bus. Stay tuned today at 4 and 5 p.m. for more info on the incident. If you see smoke burning in northern Breckenridge today, don't call 911. The U.S. Forest Service is conducting burn operations near the Tiger Dredge Trailhead in Breck. That's found east of the Breckenridge Golf Course on Tiger Road. Smoke could be visible all day. The Birds of Prey World Cup races are a go. The International Ski Federation announced over the weekend that Beaver Creek will host the annual downhill Super G and giant slalom races in early December. The races were canceled last year due to low snowfall. Racing at Birds of Prey begins December 1st with Ted Ligety, Michaela Schifrin, and international stars like defending overall champ Marcel Hirscher. Missing from the Beaver Creek lineup will be ladies downhillers like Lindsey Vonn. She is in Lake Louise that weekend for downhill. It's no mystery we live in a stunning slice of the world, and a new collection of poems from a long-lost local poet shows why. A new installment in the Unsung Masters series features Belle Turnbull, an East Coast native educated at Vassar University. She moved to Breckenridge in 1939 with her companion, novelist Helen Rich, and produced dozens of poems about her adopted hometown before her death in 1970. Her poems are some of the most widely published about Summit County and the White River National Forest, including the 10 Mile Range and, of course, Breckenridge. The book, titled Belle Turnbull, On the Life and Work of an American Master, is available on Amazon and in brick-and-mortar stores. In sports, the Breckenridge Bolts were on the ice this weekend for a series against the league-leading Steamboat Wranglers. The local junior hockey club lost both games of the away series, 5-4 on Friday and 5-2 on Saturday. Bolts forward and Vail local Tanner Calderola had two goals on the weekend, while Gavin Etzminger of Arizona had two goals and one assist. Team points leader and Summit native Luke Marsh also had a goal. The Bolts are now 3-9 on the season. They take the holiday off before opening a three-game away series against the Pikes Peak Miners on December 1st. Also in local hockey news, Summit's semi-pro adult team, the Breckenridge Vipers, won their home and season opener in grand fashion this past Saturday, 6-2 over the Boulder Bison. The Vipers are back in town this Saturday to play the Vail Yeti. The Yeti won the league title last winter. In sailing news, the Dillon Yacht Club hosted its annual awards banquet recently. Taking home awards were Hugh Knight for Rookie of the Year, the crew of the Ptarmigan for Most Improved Sailors, Kurt Robinson for Best Crew Overall, and Stuart Long for the Swim Team Award. And we can only guess that last one means Long capsized at least once this summer. And in NASCAR news, Colorado's own Martin Truex Jr. is this season's NASCAR champion. The Denver Post reports that the 37-year-old racing for Denver's Furniture Row brought home the championship yesterday. He beat former champs Kyle Busch and Kevin Harvick at the NASCAR finale. Also in pro sports, the Broncos fell to the Bengals yesterday, 17-20 in Denver, for the Broncos' sixth loss in a row. It was also Cincinnati's first win in Denver since 1975, and now the Broncos have fired offensive coordinator Mike McCoy. Quarterbacks coach and former Denver QB Bill Musgrave takes over. Phil Lindemann with Krystal 93 News.